being pushed by a young woman that is his newly appointed caretaker. It is November 22nd, 2026, and they are deep in conversation as they admire the spectacular fall colors while slowly walking down the sidewalk along the 300 block of Maynard Road. Now let's listen in on their conversation.
Karen, do you remember when Maynard Road was just a beautiful two-lane connection between Walnut and Kildare, and all these houses have big, beautiful yards?
No, that must have been way before my time. But Bill, as we think about what God is doing during the season in our lives, are you aware how he's been working in that church over there across the street? My son and I have been members there for just over 10 years. They've been so nurturing from the day we attempted to just slide into the back pew and make ourselves invisible. That congregation continues to make every effort to increasingly promote better neighborhoods and a stronger, diverse congregation because their highest goal is the good of the church, not class, race, or gender. They made me feel so welcome, safe, and secure in their love. It's now our home.
You must be kidding.
No.
A long time ago, I used to go to that church.
Oh.
Before my wife died and I had this stroke. My health went downhill. I blamed everyone around me, including God. I isolated myself. I had no reason to worship. It's been well over 10 years since I was there.
Well, I discovered that many people I know come to church pretty beaten down and empty. But I find getting together in small groups and praying for each other sometimes does as much good as a really good sermon.
That sounds fine, and if it meets your needs, that's good. At my age, I sometimes think that the best future is a return to an imagined era where things were ideal, or at least we thought they were. I like old music, old movies. Even old people understand me better. Folks my age pretty much realize we're not of much use anymore. Remember that song, Tell Me the Old, Old Story?
I do, and I can sing it for you. You probably wouldn't want me to.
Go ahead.
But if you think it is God's old story, it should not become fossilized. As believers, we have a deep respect for how it has been told in the past, and we realize that God never changes. Yet he constantly reveals himself in fresh ways, ways that change the lens through which we see him, right?
Absolutely. At least I think it's true. I experience God mostly, though, when I read the Bible. But recently, I find reading the Bible a somewhat confusing experience. Here, there's just a lot that I don't understand.
Well, Bill, I don't think you're alone in that, and certainly shouldn't feel bad. That is one of the most interesting things I've found about joining small study groups. Even though the Bible is good news, written by lots of different people, it's not so much a self-help book. It's more like a group of stories about what it means to be part of a family of God. And when you study it with others, you're building relationships, not only with God, but also with others in the group, all while we learn how God is working in our lives.
So you really think I could benefit and maybe learn something by getting involved at your church?
Well, actually, Bill, this church is already involved with you. It was through this church in their outreach ministry to the unemployed that I learned that you needed help.
So tell me, Karen, what was it that drew you to this church in the first place?
Well, let's go have a seat over here and I'll show
you. Sounds good. Can you give me a little help?
I will.
Thank you, ladies.
Well, I settled here at White Plains because they focus on supporting their youth and making sure the children are grounded in their faith. Being a single parent, I can't depend on other people in my neighborhood to assume all responsibility for setting an example for my son. But most of the members here know his name and nurture positive relationships with all the youth. And over the past 10 years, their youth ministry has expanded and become even more inclusive, reaching out to and welcoming all age groups and ethnicities.
Sounds like God is giving you specific directions. My problem is that I don't know where or if God is still speaking to me. Actually, if I were to hear his powerful voice, as Moses did, I'd probably have another stroke.
We wouldn't want that. That might give me a start as well, and I understand your comfort thing. However, God is not finished with you yet. You have an ongoing role in how he intends to encourage, love, and bless others. God does his best work with people, just like you and me. We are his hands and feet. That is why I'm so impressed with White Plains. It's like all the members just sprinkle Jesus dust everywhere they go. If you look closely, you can see God meeting real people in a real place at a real time in history and drawing them forward, calling them to a greater expression of love, unity, and discipleship. The members at White Plains are my biggest support group, and I feel the Holy Spirit working in each small group and directing activities so we learn to trust God and make a practical difference in what we do.
Karen, how can you possibly understand my comfort zone? You're 32, I'm 85. Mm-hmm. Communication with you takes a lot of commitment and effort on my part. I mean, I have to choose my words carefully so that you get the correct meaning without misinterpretation. There are times when, frankly, I just don't feel I have the effort, the energy.
Well, I agree with you that improving communications, being honest, clear, and transparent, does require being intentional. But when you love someone, everything changes. Real Christianity is not merely a religion, it's a relationship.
Right.
A relationship with people, like you and me, having a relationship with God. The more you love someone, the more you want to be with them. Remember what it was like when you fell in love with your wife?
I do.
Well, you wanted to get to know her, spend time with her, and that same love relationship is found in the services, the ministries, and the small groups at White Plains. God pursues a relationship with us, and that is more important than any other single factor in your life.
I agree. But I feel so ordinary and alone. I think it is past the time that I could join a community of passionate believers like you and make any kind of difference in this world.
Well, Bill, you already make a difference in my life. And believe me, God is far more concerned with you walking with him than he is interested in what you can do for him. The people in the Bible were ordinary people just like us. The relationships with God and God's activity through them is what made them extraordinary. When you believe that nothing significant can happen through you, then you are limiting God's power. He wants us to flourish physically, emotionally, and spiritually so that the fruit of the Spirit is evident in our lives.
I guess I could visit your church one Sunday if you and your son would pick me up, maybe.
Sure.
I'm looking forward to seeing all the changes you told me about. I believe I may be hearing God speak through you. I am sure after all this time, there has been a lot of change at White Plains. Me and my wheelchair will probably navigate through the campus much better with all the user-friendly innovations you've made.
Mm-hmm.
And it probably looks different, too.
It does. I'm certain you remember the fair booth, right?
I do.
Well, we're still volunteering and making that an active part of our ministry. What about hand biscuits?
Love them.
Well, right around this corner, the old food pantry was such a success that they opened up a small gathering spot. I can treat you to a cup of coffee that rivals Starbucks and a heavenly hand biscuit. And there's always people there playing chess or checkers, talking about where they are on their journey as a community of believers. I can't wait to introduce you to some awesome people.
I can't wait to get a cup of coffee.
Well, come on.
All of these church members out here are awesome characters too. And each woman has a story representing their journey of faith that we all share. During this journey of community of believers, we are emotionally, physically, and spiritually nurtured by each other through the Holy Spirit. It's the love of Jesus that nourishes and grows our faith so that we, the branches, produce fruit. Have you been fed today? Please join hands as we pray our closing prayer as shown on the screen.